Hello everyone, my name is Titus and today we are going to discuss on the topic gravitation. So each and every particle of the universe and every particle of the universe attracts every other particle. The force of attraction between the particles because of their masses is called gravitational force. Of attraction. According to Newton, the force of attraction acting between two particles is directly proportional to the product of their two masses, and is inversely proportional to the square of distance of separation between them. This force is directed along the line joining the two particles. This is known as Newton's universal law of gravitation. In the following figure, let there be two particles of mass says M1 and M2 with a separation R between them. Then the force of attraction F acting between them is F is directly proportional to the product of two masses M1 and M2. F is, and again, is inversely proportional to square of distance of separation between them. Combining the two, we can write F is proportional to M1, M2 by R square, or F is equal to some constant G times M1, M2 by R square, where G is a constant of proportionality. Known as universal gravitational constant. The value of G remains same everywhere on the universe. It is independent of nature of particle, temperature, medium, etc. Hence, it is known as universal gravitational constant. Hence, it is known as universal gravitational constant. We know that force is a vector quantity. Hence, it is necessary to indicate the direction also. the force F12 is equal to force on mass M1 due to mass M2. F21 is equal to force on mass M2 due to M1. If we calculate we find that F12 and F21 are equal in magnitude. But oppositely directed. Hence, we can write F12 is equal to minus of F21. Thus, we can say that they are action reaction pair. Unit and value of universal gravitational constant. Unit and value of universal gravitational constant. We know that F is equal to G M1 M2 by R square, where M1 and M2 are masses of the bodies and R is the distance separation between them. We can write G is equal to F R square by M1 M2. So, SI unit of G is equal to Newton to meters square divided by kilogram into kilogram. The value of G, G is 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. In the above equation, say equation 1, if M1 is equal to 1 kg, M2 is equal to 1 kg and R equal to 1 meter, then we find that G is equal to F. So thus we can define gravitational constant G as the force of attraction acting between two masses each of mass 1 kg placed at a separation of 1 meter. Similarly, the gravitational force of attraction between bodies of masses m1 is equal to 1 kg and m2 is equal to 1 kg separated by a distance of 1 meter is F is equal to G into 1 into 1 divided by 1 square, or we can say F is equal to G, or that is equal to 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton. So thus we can see that the gravitational force of attraction is significant between heavenly bodies but it is negligible for ordinary bodies. Regarding gravitational force, we can say that number one, the force of gravitation is always attractive. Gravitation is always attractive, unlike the electrostatic and magnetic force, where in electrostatic force we can see that the force attraction between like charges is repulsive and between unlike charges is attractive. Number two, the gravitational force between two bodies obeys the inverse square law. That is, if we double the separation between the two masses, the force of attraction between them is reduced to 1/4. Number 3, due to very small magnitude, of value of G, the gravitational force of attraction is not significant between ordinary bodies, between ordinary bodies.